12-year-old kid is killed by the police. 12-year-old kid was the victim of a cop breaking policy and speeding. Let's put up a picture for a mass of this kid. Not only have I followed this story from day one, I'm connected to this story with the family, the advocates, the attorney, and others. We have done press conferences. We have talked about this extensively on my radio show. We've talked about it here on Indisputable. I'm going to give you some background and update. The family and advocates of 12-year-old Le’Den Boykins, who was killed during a high-speed police chase, are calling for a special prosecutor and a federal investigation into the actions of the Georgia State Trooper responsible for the death of that 12-year-old child. Layden's heartbroken father, let's put his picture up. His name is Anthony Goodman, said during a news conference on January 10th, and I quote, "They decided to terminate somebody's life for a speeding ticket." That is exactly what happened. The incident occurred during the early morning hours of September 10th, 2021. Charlie Moore, 37 years of age, was driving his Kia Sorento with his son, and Le’Den Boykins inside. Boykins, who his grandmother was watching while his parents were in Michigan at a funeral, had been given permission to go out with his 14-year-old neighbor and Moore, the teen's father, to earn some money cleaning parking lots on the night of the crash. Local station WXIA reported. Let's put up the screenshot of the cop, the patrol cop. Georgia State Patrol said Moore was initially pulled over shortly after 1 a.m. by a trooper for speeding. Dash cam video shows Georgia State Patrol officer David Petersen approached the driver's side window. Petersen claimed Moore tried to evade him. That was his claim. He then posed the question to Moore, "Hey, give me your driver's license," which Moore refused, prompting Petersen to ask him to step out of the vehicle. Several minutes later, two Paulding County sheriff's deputies arrived. Moore asked for a supervisor and questioned, "What crime have I committed?" At that point, a deputy smashed the driver's side window, and Moore reacted by speeding away. Remember, they're doing all of this with kids in the car, okay? So they know kids in the car when they smash the window. They know kids are in the car when they engage in this dangerous high-speed chase, which is a violation of policy. The high-speed chase lasted roughly 8 minutes, okay? Until Petersen hit the back left bumper of Moore's car, performing the pit maneuver, literally. You do not get this accident without the pit maneuver, without the cop intentionally hitting the vehicle that he knew two children were already in. Moore and the children flipped inside of the car. And then what you hear is so disturbing. The cop gets on the radio after flipping a vehicle where he knows two black children are inside. He gets on his microphone and he says, "Pit successful. Pit successful." He repeats it over and over again. He says nothing about the children in the car, the children he knew were there. I submit to you, yes, Mr. Moore, he's partially to blame too. I get that narrative, understand that. The family is torn. But if you believe that Mr. Moore also is partially to blame for his reaction in the moment, and yes, his reaction was fear, it was definitely fear. And maybe he thought he was protecting those children because somebody just busted his window and he's surrounded by cops. He doesn't understand exactly why this is happening. So there may be context for this. But outside of that, regardless of that, we must all conclude that the cop who knew children were in the car, this should have never happened, or at least should have known, right? There's more. More on the children inside, they flipped over. The family claims the troopers should have acted differently because there were children inside of the car. They could have put up a roadblock and protected those kids. They couldn't figure out any other way than to flip that car over, Anthony Boykins asked. While Georgia's Department of Public Safety policy does not explicitly prohibit the pit maneuver because children are in the car, it requires officers to, and I quote, consider children's safety. Okay, well, they decided not to consider the children's safety. The Pawtucket County Sheriff's Office on scene told WANF, it was 1 a.m. and it was dark and the troopers were having trouble seeing who was in the vehicle. Wow, let's put up a picture of Lee Merritt, my dear brother. This is Boykins' attorney. He shared the radio traffic that indicated the officers knew that the children were actually in the car. Do you realize they're willing to lie about the death of a child? You gotta understand how depraved they are. A dispatcher can be heard on the police radio saying, there are children in the car, there are children in the car. And an unidentified officer responds saying, there are kids in the car. If I can get up there and pass them, and we'll try again. There's the vehicle coming, they better stop before they get put in the ditch. Another trooper says, remember, they already done lied twice, their credibility shot to hell. And we're still believing their narrative? We're still believing their story? At the news conference on January 10th, let's put up the pictures. Gerald Griggs, who's an attorney, he's also the Georgia NAACP president and happens to be a very good friend of mine. Gerald, on the left, called for the state attorney general, Chris Carr, on the right, to appoint a special prosecutor and for the DOJ to investigate the case. Last summer, Merritt had also called for the Pawnee County prosecutor to recuse himself and allow a special prosecutor to take over. Charlie Moore was arrested and faces charges that include first degree vehicle homicide. This is the guy who was driving. Now, they charge him with homicide. So he gets charged with murder, okay? He gets charged with first degree vehicular homicide, murder during the commission of a felony, reckless driving, endangering a child while DUI on alcohol or drugs and fleeing to elude. He still awaits trial for every single one of those charges. Meanwhile, Petersen was placed on administrative leave, paid, investigated by the GBI, then returned to work early last year. So if you believe that Mr. Moore is responsible, you have to believe the cop that did this is too, in violation of policy, in violation of protocol. And then they lied every time somebody questioned, did you know children in the car? No, we had no idea children in the car. Radio chatter, children in the car. Max, thoughts here.
I just can't get over the simple fact that this man was not even told the crime he was alleged to have committed. He simply asked what he did wrong and was met with violence. And police, as you mentioned, say they didn't know kids were in the car. They had flashlights visible in the video. You have their radio chatter. Now, should Moore have fled? No, that was a dumb idea. But at the end of the day, the one expectation we should have, and I know we don't, but that we should have, is that police, if no one else, will be the ones who follow policy and the law, that they will not flip over a vehicle full of children. And the fact that they did not call for an ambulance until well after that car flipped, even though it is standard police policy when a vehicle flips to immediately call for an ambulance and assume there is injury. They did not do that. They did not care. They were so focused on catching this guy who had disrespected them that they threw policy to the wind and now a kid is dead.
Let me pose this question. What is successful about a car flipping with children inside? What he got on that radio and said, pit successful. I mean, his adrenaline, I mean, he was proud of himself. And then they lie about the context when questioned by those in the media. Oh, we knew nothing about children. No. We would never do that if we knew children were there. And then here comes the NAACP, here comes Lee Merritt, and they're able to get their hands on the actual radio chatter. This is why it is important to have advocacy. This is why it is important to build coalition. This is why it is important to lead with heart and not corruption. A 12-year-old is dead because a cop chose to violate policy of the law. He is working again and being funded by tax dollars. And here's the irony of it. He's a Georgia trooper, which means the family of the 12-year-old he killed is funding his salary.